Okay. Hi everyone. My name is Nasreen. I'm a lactation specialist, childbirth educator, and a peer counselor and a certified trainer. This is just a small video talk about the breastfeeding during COVID and about explaining to the mothers how they can be able to breastfeed or continue or maintain their milk supply in case of any COVID infection, which is now affecting most of the countries. Basically, we need to make sure that we follow the recommendations as per the WHO and UNICEF and CDC, that you should wash your hands more frequently as much as you can, especially if you're touching a surface where you doubt that someone was touching, or you brought some things or grocery things from outside, or any boxes you were getting or anything you buy from outside. So it's better to clean your hands and wash your hands perfectly and thoroughly with soap and water for almost 20 seconds. And plus, you can empty your containers or the food stuff or grocery stuff in clean containers or bags from home. One of the main things also to maintain your social distance, and you should avoid your touching nose and mouth. Practice respiratory hygiene. If you have fever or cough or difficulty breathing, seek medical clearly, and it's better to call the medical centers and hospitals before deciding to go out from hospital. Stay informed about all the information needed in the hospitals and from the hospitals. So washing hands very effectively through soap and water, or in case if you're outside home, you can use the sanitizers or alcohol-based sanitizers or any type to clean your hands. Very important to maintain the distance, at least 1 meter or 3 feet between yourself and the other one, especially if you suspect someone is sneezing or sick with any types of infection. Not even coronavirus, just in case we never know if he's carried to the infection or not yet, or maybe he didn't investigate yet. So if you're so close to them, it's very important to make this distance, because you might get a droplet or a splash of the cough or the droplets, which can really affect you unnecessarily. And again, wash your hands and clothes after entering home, basically. Self-isolation is a very important part of the recommendations of the national recommendations, that most of the people are now at home following the instructions of the government instruction that you should be at home, even working from home, school and studying from home. Now, in case if you're sick with coronavirus or any types of flu, because we never know if you're really suspected to be a carrier or not yet, if you didn't investigate, or you may be in contact with someone, we never know that if he's infected or not. Make sure that you cover your cough or sneezing by your tissue, carrying a tissue, or using the elbow, just to prevent the splash of the droplets while coughing and sneezing. And if you're using a tissue, make sure you discard it carefully in a trash or a rubbish bin or a can and a closed bag, and discard it safely so it doesn't be exposed to kids or someone else. Hand washing is very important, because hand wash can really get rid of most of the viruses affecting your hand, not even the coronavirus. But it's mainly sure that you should wash your hands between the fingers is very important, and also to maintain 20 to 30 seconds with soap and water. And if you wish to, so as we said, it's just maintaining your daily wash of hands, especially if you're catching anything, and even before cooking your food or touching the baby, or even before eating your food, and after changing the baby or cleaning and washing the baby as well. And also avoid touching your face and nose and the areas that you might suspect a virus could enter your body and start the infection. It's very important that you understand that why do you want to stay at home. It's very important because especially if you have some fever or cough or any signs of flu, because we don't want you to spread the infection to someone else if it could be coronavirus. So some hospitals will ask you to stay at home and will ask you to investigate according to their protocol, when to investigate and when the results will be ready. And if suspected to be a carrier or confirmed coronavirus, then they will ask you to stay stay at the hospital or any place where they tell you to stay away from people and isolate yourself from others, especially family members, kids and ladies, or even pregnant ladies. So a lady who's pregnant or breastfeeding, suspecting her husband or any of the family member to be carrier or having flu, should isolate herself very soon, even before the investigation is done, to make sure that she's safe from catching infection for breastfeeding or mothers who are pregnant. So again, watch and keep an eye updated with the national and information guided by the national newspapers or social media. Now everyone is on social media using the Ministry of Health, MOH, or DHA, Dubai Health Authority, or HAD, Abu Dhabi Health Authority, or Siha. All these people are so active on the social media, especially Instagram. So you can follow their instructions and new news and recommendations. Stay informed, as we said, from the healthcare provider. Please don't take information from local people or any person who tend to feel spreading news from here and there. Make sure you can contact the information and the advices and correct decisions from the healthcare workers and healthcare providers, because any person who's using his own knowledge and his own information based on, you know, just general Google information could really put you into wrong situations of spreading or getting infected. Now, for the breastfeeding or pregnant mother, if she's aiming to breastfeed after the pregnancy, it's very important to know that. But during pregnancy, the studies even didn't show that there's a transmission of a mother to baby through the pregnancy, so baby could be safe. The baby could really catch the virus after pregnancy by handling mistake, or catching someone who's or touching the baby by someone who's infected. So the transmission will not be during pregnancy, and there's no evidence till now for the babies who were born where mother infected with the coronavirus, that they had some any anomalies or any born with such, you know, situations. And the mother has the right to choose her natural way of delivery or giving birth, so she shouldn't be forced to C-sections or emergency situations unless there's a real need for the safety of the mother or the baby, so she can still have her natural delivery or normal delivery through the hospital settings. Now, again, in case if you're pregnant or breastfeeding, you should make sure that you practice respiratory hygiene, could put your masks and wash your hands thoroughly, and also routinely cleaning and washing. So after delivery, if you're born in a baby-friendly hospitals, because in the non-baby-friendly hospitals, they don't do the early skin-to-skin breastfeeding. But in baby-friendly hospitals, skin-to-skin and early breastfeeding could be one of their practice. However, internally, they might delay or do some internal changes just in case if the settings or the hospital protocols and to protect you or the baby from direct infection through people around. So you might get an early or a little delayed of skin to skin or even temporary separation, but even though as soon as you are with the baby, either infected or not infected, you can do the skin to skin after washing your hands and putting a mask and put the baby skin to skin or breastfeeding, or even after you can express your milk and use the milk if needed. So again, if you're breastfeeding and you were having a baby born in a baby-friendly hospital, expecting to do early skin-to-skin breastfeeding if you're not infected. But if you're infected, some hospitals might prefer that to separate the baby temporarily and then wait for the mother to wash her hands or face or whatever, and to protect herself from spreading the infection. So there might be some changes internally, but don't worry, the hospitals will guide you to the best practice as baby-friendly hospitals. For the non-baby-friendly hospitals, again, it's not a practice that they will do early skin-to-skin and breastfeeding, so most of the babies will be born, kept away, either you're a clean mother or infected mother. So you can ask for the baby to be kept with you if possible and breastfeed or express your milk or do skin-to-skin if you wish, but again, you have to maintain your respiratory hygiene and hand wash. Now, if the hospital is not baby-friendly and they don't want to infect the baby and they don't support that decision, you have to follow the protocol of that hospital, because they're not baby-friendly, so they don't know exactly what is to be followed. Right or wrong in the protocol. So comparing your situation with a mother, what happened or what should be done, it's based on where did she has her baby. So if it's a baby in a a baby-friendly hospital born or a non-baby-friendly hospital born, it makes differences. So please be clear with the informations. All women should be early, according to the recommendations, direct skin-to-skin or breastfeeding, and share the room if possible, but using the precautions. Now, again, it could be not the not the hospital settings, which it could be the father or the mother decided that even if safe baby was born with no infection, she might decide not to have the baby with her, just to make sure that she doesn't want to spread the infection to the baby for any mistake of handling the baby. So you can still have that decision. It's your decision, not even the hospital decision. If you wish, you can give the baby to a father or family member and keep expressing your milk and use this express milk to the baby. But before expressing your milk, you need to wear the mask, wash your hands first perfectly with soap and water, wash the items, express your milk, and either you wish to give it or as you decided, another member of the family can give the express milk to him. Now, the third option also could be if it's in a culture accepted that you should again screen the mother from being any blood-borne disease infections like HIVs, HPVs, or anything, or even she should be suspected to be clean from coronavirus. If you wish to get a donor milk from her, she can express the milk and handle it and give it to you. Or temporary, like Muslim countries or some with the rules of Muslim conditions, that you need to get permission from both families and the husbands, and plus to announce that this baby was really fed by the next lady. But sometimes it could be a cousin or a sister-in-law or let us say a sister in the family. You can give that baby safely if she doesn't have any infections and let her feed for that total duration of 14 days or 15 days until you're clear from the infection and get your baby back. So either you do the direct breastfeeding with precautions as recommendation and if the hospital allows this, plus if you wish to do it with your baby. Now, second option, it could be you might express your own milk and give it to the baby with following the precautions, as we said before. And the third option could be a donor milk who expresses the milk and give it to you, but she should be clean and clear from coronavirus and also other blood diseases. If she had a new baby and you suspect that she knows that she's clean from any and screen medically that she doesn't have any infections, so you can use her own milk with precautions. And other option, you might give the baby to one of your family members or close friends, trusted people. For 14 days, they can do direct breastfeeding with their other siblings if they wish and get back your baby to you. So all these alternatives, it could be accepted, but make sure you do the precautions of hygiene and hand washing and sterilizing. And in case if someone else is taking care of the baby for breastfeeding, you make sure they're clean with from infections or any problems, even other than COVID-19. As we said, pregnant people have no changes in their bodies that may increase the risk for some infections. It's just a matter that all pregnant ladies will be prone to infection even with no coronavirus issue. Because we tend to advise the mothers who are pregnant to reduce the, let us say, outgoing for crowded places, eat raw meat or anything not washed very properly during pregnancy. So the same instruction goes to coronavirus, but we are more conscious to that because we don't want her to be getting any such complications, not because of coronavirus. It's sometimes her medical situation with coronavirus can cause complications. So she might be diabetic or she might be hypertensive or with any other medical disease, with the infection she might get worse. So again, coronavirus will not cause that infection directly. It could be because of other underlying medical conditions. And many mothers are safe with no infections, but for the cases who are suspected to be infected, they were fine, healthy, everything was fine, baby was given to them back for such cases, and other cases were separated temporarily. Again, it's your decision or hospital or protocol or the country you follow their protocols. So make sure that you are doing very well with breastfeeding according to the alternatives. We said that transmission is not really, clear till now. But again, most of the babies were born healthy, not infected. The transmission could be after delivery. And again, they said there's no also detection on virus in the amniotic fluid or any samples from the breast milk as well. As we said, washing your hands is very important temporarily. And also keep washing your hands and hygiene daily as much as you can. If you are sick, choose to express your breast milk because you're sick, or you decided not to have the baby directed by you or handled by you, so you can express your milk and give it to the father or any family member to help you. So these are my references, the CDC and WHO. Thank you. And you can follow me on my accounts, as I said, the Lamsa Lamsa accounts. My account on this is my account, the Lamsa Lamsa account, or Lamsa for Facebook, Lamsa Lamsa, and for Instagram, Lamsa Lamsa 1. And you can also take my WhatsApping number 050-146-1427 if you are in UAE.